What's up, guys, and welcome back to the Chaotic Battles channel. Today we've got an epic 3v3 at Cedar Creek Morning. Soltok's taking the right wing cavalry all the way around the left side. He's going Mongol. Let's see if it works. Safari's down 2 cav units, but he still has 4 more. It'll be a legendary flanking of the artillery if it's successful. Canister versus rifles. Here we go. Oh! Oh! About to be another volley. Oh, that definitely did it. If they get one more off, that'd be crazy. He's flanking all of First Corps artillery here. Freaking epic. I didn't really get to appreciate this live because I was kind of stuck on my own front, but this is freaking epic. Oh, and the canisters. Canister going everywhere. These volleys are epic. He's just rolling up the whole battery. Because I gotta say, this is pretty good artillery position. A little bit of friendly fire there, but it's worth it. He literally just took out all First Corps artillery. I'm curious to see if he makes it to 6 corps or not. Now I'm opening up against Vandor over here. I've got all my Georgias in the front line with maybe 1 or 2 Alabamas in there as well. Looks like the cab might have finally gotten stopped. We'll see. 6th Corps has got all of his artillery pretty much aiming right at it. I mean, just taking out all of 1st Corps artillery was massive. Except for that one, but still half of it's only going to have 2 guns at most. Yeah, looks like First Corps is going to attack this tree line. Let's see if he gets there. Oh, that was major. Let's see if he gets a volley off in time. I don't think he will. Oh, nah, I didn't. It looks like Pender's finally going to be going up against 14th Corps here. It'll be the battle for the graveyard. I got the Alabamas out here squaring up against 1st Corps. Right wing here is going to take these woods, and it's going to be a really tough spot. It's going to have high ground and woods cover. Oh, looks like the right wing barely got his artillery out of there. Isn't really the line battle I wanted to be in, but I'm in it. I like this little flanking maneuver he's got right here. It's aesthetically pleasing too. Oh, when he's mixing in the canister too? Oh, perfect combination. Beautiful. Such good artillery positioning. Wow, look at that. You already got one. Clutch moves by Pender. At this point, I'm gonna send my Texans over here to this flank right here. The fight between first and right wing here is intensifying in these woods. It's not an easy position to attack. And now right wing springing his flank. He's putting canister into the 21st Ohio. Oh, let's see if he gets off any more before he goes down. He's about to rout. They took a lot of damage here. Still, though, they did about 40 casualties on that 21st Chevron to Ohio. Probably a smart move from Pender to back up a little bit. Make that distance a little bit more, because 21st Ohio is just going to machine gun everyone down. It's about to go down. Soul springing his trap from all sides. I'm coming in from the side to help while trying to turn into the side here and maybe get into 6th horse flank if possible, if practicable. Texans always move them. Where are my other Texans? Oh, there they are. 5th Texas. Artillery shots. The graveyard of death. Fire so fast. not doing as much damage to that 21st Ohio ever since those Napoleons went down. Like first score is right flank is pretty much gone, and their center still has a couple units out here on the left, and I'm sure he'll have a couple recover and trying to move that way. It's time for a glorious 5th Texas charge. I'm pretty sure they eat a volley to the face here. There's some of it. Getting desperate over here. 14th Corps is meleeing Pender's division. Ironically, there's Perrin. Oh, some pretty heavy volleys right there. These units are face to face. Thank you. epic charge. It ain't gonna be easy to bring down that Chevron 137 Pennsylvania, though. Oh, is that a volley? Or is that like a cannon shot? Is that just like a super well angled round shot or something? Yeah, the battle is definitely over. Right over there. This is the last vestige of defense. It's like a perfect B. That little 3-pound, or that little 3-gun 12-pound howitzer is doing some damage. Got fucking 4 chevrons already. I didn't know they're having. Oh yeah, I guess I have a little bit of artillery left. This is a crazy battle over here. Ha! Good old right wing doing some kill farming. Point's taking a lot of artillery. Man, right wing melee is so strong. Epic last stand of the general. Alright guys, and with the exception of the artillery, that's about it. Alright guys, before it's all over, we're gonna check out the battlefield real quick. Massive amounts of bodies over here on this wing. Or flank of the battlefield. Side of the battlefield, whatever you want to call it. Be the battle for the graveyard. Charge. I don't think this graveyard is going to be big enough to accommodate everyone. Bodies in every direction. Looks like the general's taking out the last of the artillery here. Alright guys, and that's it. Thank you for watching. That was a fun battle. Looks like the forces were just about even. You know, I mean, pretty much similar numbers here. The only discrepancy is the difference between killed, obviously. Damn. Texans and Alabamans. That first Texas and 44th Alabama were ridiculous. Soul Talk probably had some ridiculous melee stats too. And Ethan definitely had some good ones on his cannons. Alright guys, thank you for watching.